one quick thing. Careful with like smacking the table or touching the table. It's gonna be loud as fuck.
Okay.
Sorry. That's the only thing. Everything else is fine.
Sorry.
Sorry, Will.
Won't touch it.
Goddamn sorry. Now I'm gonna be thinking about the table the whole time.
God. Worst producer.
Hi, everyone. Welcome back to the Lion's Den Podcast. We're here in New York City. Make sure to follow us and rate and review and subscribe.
Do you want me to do it?
Yeah.
Welcome back to the Lion's Den Podcast. Please don't forget to rate, review. You know, when we're not in the Lion's Den, it's weird.
It's so weird right now.
Welcome back to the Lion's Den Podcast. Please continue to rate, review, leave a comment, five-star rating. I don't know what I'm doing here.
Will distracted me because he's still in the bathroom.
Goes into the bathroom.
Sorry. Will's over there for all you TikTokers that miss him.
Come in, say hi.
Say hi.
Hi.
Nice. There he is.
This could be the last video before the hurricane hits.
I know. We got a hurricane coming in.
Actually, by the time this comes out, we could be gone.
From New York.
Yeah. No, I mean hurricane-wise.
You dead?
Seems aggressive. They're shutting things down.
What floor are we on right now?
19. They can't see the window. It's just us two.
We're on the 19th.
And I'm doing this again. See?
We're on the 19th.
Is it fine?
It's just like, yeah. Some don't, you know.
Look, we're new at this on the road stuff. We even brought stuff that we're not using. You know what? Give us a break, people.
Yeah, we're here.
For all your members only content, there's.
Why'd you get so loud? For all your members only content.
Patreon.com/thelionsdenpod.
Bod.
That's
Patreon. Why is Jason falling asleep right now? New York, it's a different zone out here. We're figuring ourselves out.
We're doing some. The shows have been going well.
They went okay.
A lot of you guys showed up, which is amazing.
Which was awesome.
We had a great time. What do we got? Two tonight at Gotham.
Two tonight at Gotham.
I got a spot at the Cellar at 9:15. The Cellar. I got a spot at the Cellar, 9:15. I have not met anybody in New York that talks like that, by the way.
Yeah, that's true. You're right.
Not one person.
Yeah.
Also, that whole, like, New Yorkers are so rude. No.
Yeah.
So sweet, so nice, so honest.
It's also because we're in the nicer parts of the city, so it's a lot of people coming into the city.
Right.
We're probably all thinking the same thing. I've become extremely northeast here. I've been yelling at people.
Mostly
remember
on bikes.
The bikes? I was yelling at the people the other day.
He just randomly yells out, "The rules apply!
The rules apply!" Because they've run through red lights and shit, and they're getting on the sidewalks. Mm-hmm. And then I just snapped at somebody. I went and got some pizza here, some fucking New York pizza.
You went and got a slice.
I went and got a slice. And this guy almost backed into me, and I went, "Hey!" Like that, and it scared the shit out of everybody around me. And when I looked at him, he did this to me. He went,
"Mm."
And I go, "Oh, that made me the most mad. He almost killed me and my brother.
You wanted to fight."
I love this city. It has the same energy that anxious energy.
My favorite Morin's in town.
Yeah, Jared.
Sorry.
Yeah, my older brother's in town.
I'm excited about tonight. I'm excited and a little bit nervous because
the Cellar.
Yeah, the Cellar. Yeah. If you guys don't know, is kind of like the it's not kind of like it's the East Coast version of the Comedy Store. It's the one you want to be a part of and stuff. But even though I'm not in town that much, I'm excited to be a part of the Cellar because they have a Vegas location.
Yeah. Oh yeah.
And that's only a 45-minute flight from LA, and I can get some pretty good Vegas gigs out of it. I'm not trying to jinx it.
Mm-hmm.
Whatever he seems to think. I FaceTimed with Godfrey last night, and he's like, just do you. You're going to do great.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He's got cool hair.
He always has cool hair.
I don't know. And he's always ripped. Doesn't he know karate?
Yeah, we kind of bonded on martial arts stuff, because he grew up doing martial arts as well.
Will had a good set last night. He didn't know how to get on the stage and disappear from the owner of the club. But,
So last night, Will has a guest spot on the show.
Decided to walk to another club.
One of the biggest comedy agents in the biz is there. Yeah. And he just disappeared.
Yeah, where were you going?
Never performed at Gotham before, am I wrong?
You're right.
Obviously.
Enters the stage from the wrong side.
I've never seen anybody go from that side.
Because he set his camera up on the complete opposite side of the room because he needed to do, you have to record that set. Get the fuck out of here. Of course, it's a TikTok thing. We understand. And
it's also annoying. He had a good set, which pissed me off because they made me go find him from the green room.
Yeah, that sucks.
And I'm like, I don't know where he is. I don't know.
And he was like, I have notes. I need to find Will.
Yeah, he goes, where's Will? I go,
I feel like you were hiding from the notes, to be honest.
No. Well, I don't know if you can hear me. Hopefully you can hear me over there. But I have never been there before. And the only stairs to the stage I saw were on that side.
That's so
I didn't see anyone walk in there. I had no idea. So I said, oh, there's stairs there. That must be where.
It's usually
it's kind of cute.
What's crazy though is when I did Gotham Comedy Live, they had us
in that way.
From that side.
Thank you. So it's not that crazy. It's not. People act like I rappelled in from the ceiling.
Well, like, it's like no one could find you.
But the funny part is you were gone.
Yeah, I know.
And everybody's like, this kid is next and he's nowhere.
Fuck. I'm glad I did well. If I sucked after that would have been like, who the fuck is this idiot?
You know what would have sucked is if they didn't know where you were and just said, fuck it, let's not bring him up. Let's just bring Jason.
Yeah, that would have really
sucked. That's what I was thinking they were going to do, to be honest.
Yeah.
Well, it's even funnier also in Stand Up New York, they brought me up as Eric Burkhart.
Why? Oh, do you remember what I got brought up as last night?
No.
Jason Cummings?
No, you didn't.
Oh, yeah, that's right. He told me that.
Really?
Remember, he fucked the host fucked my name up
and his up.
What do you call you?
Brent Morin.
Brent Morin. It's Morin. Why is that so hard to... Because you say the name Morin.
I literally have
Brent
a
Morin.
I'm Brent Morin. For this reason. And then on the first show, he goes, you guys ready for Brent Morin? And it's like...
stuttered my name. Jason Cummings, tell us. And then apologized to me. Sorry for fucking your name up.
Well, because
on stage.
He got in trouble for fucking my name up. And then then when he brought you up, he gets off like that. Does that kind of look and he goes.
Never working here again.
He goes, fuck, I called him Cummings. And I go, what? And he goes, Jason Cummings. I go, why? He goes, I don't know.
I've had Justin Cummings a few times too.
Yeah. One time I was hosting and I legit forgot the person's name. I just made up a name. I called him Tyler. Didn't even know who he was. That was pretty bad. Yeah. I've been there. I sympathize with fucking it up.
I definitely fucked
up. And that, here's the thing. In that situation, what you have to do is go, you know what? I'm drawing a blank. I don't remember who's next. Who's next?
Yeah, that's too much pressure.
To do that. That feels like, because it takes all the energy out of the room, makes it all weird. That's why.
Yeah, but it's also good to just go, ladies and gentlemen, Tyler. Like, what?
Or something. It's too bad.
You know what else is bad? Is when there's somebody that you're bringing up that for some reason they are famous somewhere. But you know nothing about them.
Yeah.
And then you look like the asshole that doesn't know anything about this person. I guess this person's done a few things or something. And then you look them up. They're like, oh, 4 million followers. Cool, 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 cool. Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, but here's my thing with that. If you're famous somewhere else, just don't be an asshole about it. Like, Jack Whitehall is a friend. And he's not an asshole about people fucking up his shit when it comes to the States. I can't believe I'm saying that.
The States.
But he's not. Also, I heard a beep. You should check the camera.
No, it's just the bed.
No, good call. Jesus.
Really?
You an X-Men?
I don't know. I heard a beep or I'm dying. But
he's a bat.
I remember people, they're like, Jack LaHall? And they were bringing him up. And then I looked him up because I was like, who is this guy? Why is everybody, like industry coming to see him? And then I realized the guy plays the O2 Arena.
That's insane.
Sells it out 3 shows in fucking London.
That's insane.
And he's doing a bar show with me in the Valley.
If you don't know, O2 Arena is like, I'm not bored, I'm just tired. It's like the Garden here or like Staples at home.
Yeah, yeah, like where you see your local NBA team. They do bullshit there.
First time I ever heard of a comedian doing that was Kevin Hart.
The O2?
The O2, yeah.
Doesn't Russell do it?
I think he did.
Russell Peters?
I would assume.
Yeah.
I would assume so too. A lot of comics are doing like the Garden shit.
Joe Rogan is on the marquee over here for October. Who else? Not me, obviously. Should be.
The Eagles are playing tomorrow.
Eagles.
Well, actually, is that going to happen with the hurricane? I was supposed to go laugh with my friend at the Eagles and then realize I love all their songs. That was supposed to happen.
They have great songs. Name one.
Hit Me Up the River.
What's that, man?
Hit Me Up the River.
It's called Hit Me Up the River. Yeah. How's it go?
Hit me.
Oh, yes.
Hit that river on a Friday.
Hit me up on the river. I remember that one. Yeah.
Right?
Yep.
That was a good hit.
There's also Hotel California, and there's
Hotel California.
And then
in a wider world, in a waiting place, there's something on the sunrise.
No.
Hello in Hotel California.
There's something on the sunrise.
Yeah,
dude.
That's what it is.
And I'm a definite twister. She got the Mercedes Benz. She got a little pretty, pretty friend.
What was that in? See, I relate songs to movies.
Hotel California?
That part you just sang was in a movie, a very famous movie. I think it was a Coen Brothers movie.
You know a song I love?
Was that Big Lebowski?
Maybe, yeah.
It might have been a Big Lebowski.
Her head is Tiffany twisted. She's got the Mercedes Benz. She's got a lot of pretty, pretty boys. She calls friends.
It was. You know what it was? When Jesus... the first scene you see John Turturro as Jesus, Jesus or whatever.
Yeah.
And fucking Jesus, man. You know, and he's doing this with the balls, and then he throws the strike. That song is over, and then it cuts into this thing. So nice. I do know the Eagles.
You know what song I love? You know what song is great? What? Eagles song? Damn, it was just in my head. Life in the Fast Lane.
Life in the Fast Lane. Man, they have a lot of hits.
Yeah.
Well, look at that. I'm an Eagles fan.
Desperado.
They did Desperado?
You better come to your senses.
I can see Will's face, too. You didn't know that the Eagles did all those songs.
I can name one Eagles song, Hotel California. They missed me completely.
Yeah. You know how insulting that would be to them?
They, sorry, also, guys, they didn't miss you.
Huh?
They didn't miss you.
Yeah, that's fine.
You missed them.
Yeah, true.
That's where I was going. That'd be so insulting to the band. Sorry, you guys missed me.
Sorry, you guys missed me. They're just sitting in front of a shelf with tons of Grammys.
Yeah.
Oh, we missed you? Sorry, we gotta do the garden right
hey,
now.
Thanks for having us at the show. Everybody, well, hey, you guys missed me. Fuck you, Desperado. Fuck you.
Frame of reference for the Eagles is Big Lebowski when he goes, man, I fucking hate the Eagles. So as a kid, I would go, yeah, fuck the Eagles.
So I was right on Lebowski. Why did you help me when I was searching?
I just remember that part. I don't remember what part of the movie it was.
I love as a kid, you're like, yeah, fuck the Eagles because of the Big Lebowski.
Yeah, that's what I was like, yeah, they probably suck.
I can't really talk shit because I literally.
He would have been the best person for like peer pressure when, because you know he gives in.
Yeah, I think I give him more.
I don't do a lot.
No, because you don't like confrontation.
Yeah.
And you don't like confrontation to the point where you think a normal conversation is confrontation.
Yeah.
It's crazy to me.
Why?
And deeper issues. It's the whole thing.
Are you beaten?
No.
Mentally, probably.
Mentally, kind of. Anyways, we should also make note that we're recording this on a phone.
Yeah.
We haven't said that yet, and people are going to notice that it's like...
I think that everyone...
We've only done 13 minutes.
Listen, guys. Every one of you have to understand,
yeah,
we're shooting this in a hotel room,
mm-hmm,
and we're not in the Lion's Den.
Nope.
And we don't have all our equipment.
Uh-uh.
And we're doing this for you. We're doing everything we can.
Yeah.
Everything we can,
yeah,
to bring this shit to you. So don't complain about the sound. Don't complain about the audio and the video.
Video's
gonna be fun.
Video looks like an independent film. It's actually pretty good lighting. It's probably better than the sound.
How's the lighting look on this side of me?
It's actually really good.
Okay, because it usually makes me.
No, it's good because
Will's making a fucking face, dude.
What?
He's making a face.
No, it looks good
in post.
We'll fix what in post, man?
Face.
We'll add a jawline.
Fuck this, dude. And by the way, you have a jawline.
Let's just add a jawline.
Just a whole, put a Photoshop, a whole new face.
What's that one? What's that one filter on Instagram that everybody's using?
Oh, yeah.
Look, there's a new filter.
It's the guy with the dope cheekbones, and it's what I call the Matt Rife.
That's so
sorry, Matt. Matt Rife filter. It's just way too good of just cheekbones really and lips and chin. Yeah.
Beautiful.
Yep.
Yeah, no, you look good.
Thank you. Life in the fast lane.
You know what it is? You're getting in your own head because you had late night snacks.
I did. Fuck.
And that, by the
way, let's talk about fatty habits. We'll talk about fatty habits.
It's New York. What are you supposed to do?
I'm in New York. I don't like to eat after 7. However, at about, I don't know, 2 a.m. last night.
You turned into a gremlin.
I stopped at the New York Pizza, something number, whatever the fuck it is. And I got 2 slices.
Yeah.
I got a cheese pizza and I got a pineapple and whatever the fuck.
You got pineapple at 2 a.m.?
I'm surprised I didn't have heartburn.
Usually, I've had nothing but heartburn this entire trip.
Usually I'm fire out of both ends when I'm doing that.
My friend Mike Craig is with me. Mike at the car, for people that don't, my act. But he's really in shape. He looks like Wahlberg in the 90s with his body.
Crazy.
And he has a master's in nutrition and he knows fitness.
He's so, a phys ed like guy.
And being around him, when I got a fucking street dog, a hot dog, at 2 in the morning in Times Square.
Did he just shake his head?
He went, really, Brent? And I was like, you know what? It's gone now.
You don't want to look at it anymore? Yeah. Fine.
Hi, can I get a COVID? Thank you. Like everything else shuts down, but those stairs are just wide open. Okay.
Before I got my 2 slices, I almost got a Chili's cheese dog at this spot because it looked and smelled fucking amazing.
Yeah, it's New
York.
And
if it wasn't for these little asshole kids that were in the late teens, early 20s, whatever these fuckers were, talking about the nerdiest shit in front of me.
You were so mad.
I was like... the fuck is going on? They wouldn't get out of the way.
Yeah.
So this kid Ethan that was hanging out with us was laughing because I went like this. This is fucking too much. And I said it right to them. I go, this is too fucking much. And I walked walked out.
You were so mad.
Oh, man.
You're like, fucking kids.
When you
bullshit.
Order, listen, I don't care what state it is, New York, California, yeah. whatever the fuck. When you're done ordering your food, step aside yeah, yeah. so the next person can order. Uh-huh. These guys started having a conversation about comic books or whatever the fuck they were talking about.
Yeah, there's
all of them, their hair
you.
Was just stupid. Sorry. They had stupid hair, all of them. They all wore glasses. They all looked like they all looked like alt comics.
They were
no offense to alt comics, but they looked like fucking guys
they
that do comedy.
Like they were in Arcade
in
Fire.
Only coffee shops. So yeah.
Honestly, you know what I hate more than that? And I think I've talked to you personally about this, but I don't think I said it on the podcast. Okay. Any middle-aged white women, stop. Just stop with the coupons and stop with the attitude and stop talking to the cashier. There's 15 people behind
buddy.
You. Every time I'm in a line anywhere, I have to deal with, well, it says you take that till the third. It's like, no, they don't take it.
I was in CVS the other day. The woman finishes her purchase. And then they just have a fucking conversation with each other. The cashier and the woman. Yeah, these are my favorite. I really get these all the time. And there's like other people in line. And you get, East Coast gets this thing where everything's, they're rude over here. I was the biggest asshole in the line. Everybody else is just waiting.
Yeah.
I was like, yo, let's fucking go.
At least here, there's an anxious movement.
Yeah.
But, oh my God, anytime. I cut off a woman at the Whole Foods when I was buying stuff when I got here because I went, no, too old. And I just cut her off because I was like, I know what she's going to do. And I was right because I stayed behind for a second. First thing she does, she pulls out paper coupons. And everybody behind
checkbook?
Her is,
did she pull out the checkbook?
Oh, God, I might as well. I go, how do you even get those still?
Right.
Fucking.
And they by the way, they send them to your phone. You can get them on your phone. There's these things called cellular phones. And it's pretty crazy the shit you can do on them. So anyways, the asshole comic book store kids, I thought, you know what? I got mad and left. But then I thought, you know what? They just saved me from eating this shit too
much. That's true.
Then I walked a block.
Yeah, then you
and wafting out of a pizza spot. Oh, God damn it. So I went and got it. And of course, Ruben Paul was like, nah, I'm not getting anything. And I'm like, of course you're not. You're in amazing shape now.
Yeah, he's lost a lot of weight. He looks great.
Yeah. Our buddy Ruben Paul's in town. Shout out Ruben Paul. Yeah. We got to hang out last night. It was really cool. He said if he gets shit done on time tonight, then
he's going
to
hang?
He'll come
nice.
Hang out. Yeah, he's
we're going to see him. I want to tell the kid dying story. But
Yeah. Do it.
I think I want to have rosé for this because I'm actually affected. Okay, so on my way to New York City. What?
This is so funny, dude.
Oh, fuck it, dude. We're in New York. It's making the funniest noise.
Okay. It's a heavy pour.
What are you, my wife?
Can I have a sip? I want to see what it tastes like. First of all, I'm going to smell it first.
It's more fruity, I think.
Oh.
Actually, what is it? Zinfandel. I actually don't know what Zinfandel is.
Yeah, wine, dude. Fuck that. Ugh. Rosé all day.
Oh, that's fucking horrible.
Yeah. How much was it?
$4. Fuck. All right, so here's what happened. So I'm flying from LAX to New York City and meeting these guys. And I got a ticket in premium economy, you know? Like the nice seats are a little bigger. It's not first class. I don't know what else you get in there, but you're there. And it's a big plane, so it's three seats. Nobody's next to me. And then all of a sudden this kid who looked like a professional skater, reeking of marijuana, sits next to me on the plane. And when he sits next to me, first thing he says to me, he goes, man, I just had a pixie stick. Sorry, dude. A pixie stick. I guess it's like an edible or something. Well, you know edibles.
I've never heard of a pixie stick like that. It sounds like a different drug.
Pixie stick is a candy one from when I was a kid that they gave out on Halloween.
But they have a weed version of that, I thought.
Oh, so it's weed or not something else.
So they're lacing, they're lacing pixie sticks.
See,
I got it.
Jay, Google pixie stick drug.
Yeah.
Really?
Just to see.
Hold on, guys. Here we go. Ready? Pixie stick drug.
Want to do it and not stutter? Pixie stick drug.
Here we go. Pixie stick drug. In Colorado, they were originally called Wizzy Sticks, made by Weeby Infused, and are now called Sticks 2Xs, made by At Home Baked. Each stick contains 50 milligrams THC and 25 milligrams CBD.
Oh, okay. Although, so it's edible.
Yeah, although an individual dose is listed at 10.
That's not accurate. 50 milligrams?
Well, he reeked of weed, and then he got on, and then he's like, yeah, sorry, man, I just had a pixie stick. This will be the last time I talk to you. I'm sorry. And I went, I don't have to apologize, man. It's fine. You know, I'm like a bartender. It's a big person to sit next to.
I don't like talking to people on planes anyway.
Yeah, so I was like, all right, I'm fine with that. And he was kind of smaller, so I went, we'll be fine. Then cut to about a minute later, all of a sudden, his head dips. And he starts drooling. And I didn't know what to say to get someone's attention. So I started going, different drool. Excuse me. Flight attendants are helping other passengers get on the plane. It's still boarding. So I kept going, different drool, different drool, different drool. Because it's like one long thing going down.
Oh, jeez.
And I'm like,
oh, that made me so mad.
It just seemed like dead drool. So I was like.
Look at.
So I started going, different drool. And then I went, hey, different drool. And then I realized.
Worst person in an emergency, by the way. What the fuck is he yelling different drool
polar
for?
Polar opposite of what my little brother would have done. Because I realized after that, they're like, what? What is he, a Tourette's? What the fuck is wrong with him? So I yelled at, and then finally, a flight attendant sees me. She goes, what? And I go, because all of a sudden he's.
Jeez. Always convulsing?
Yeah. And then there was happened to be an EMT in the middle section with the three seats. And he goes, he's having a seizure, and he had a fucking case on him. I forgot what it's called. My mom told me, but it's like they all carry it or something.
Who's and they all? Like people that get seizures?
No, like I guess EMTs and doctors that carry case. Because he immediately pulls out a case and puts gloves on.
Oh, he was ready. Yeah. That's awesome.
And then I moved the guy's seat all the way back. So because the only thing I do know with seizures is you don't want to choke on your own shit, you know? So you have to have your head back.
I put a piece of wood in their teeth.
I wanted to put my finger in there, but it was different drool. So, so all of a sudden, he's seizuring in front of me, and I'm just sitting there, and they were like, get out, get out. And they move me, and I'm just now watching this guy convulse in front of me. And I'm like, and they go, sir, over here. And I go, yeah, okay. And then they bring on the actual EMTs from, it's offensive to the guy. The guy did a good job. The EMTs from L.A.
Who were dressed like EMTs.
Yes. Yeah, not that guy was an actual EMT too.
The guy was one was undercover.
Yeah, one was undercover.
Yeah, yeah. And one was plain clothes, and yeah. The other uniformed officers.
So then they end up. I don't know if the guy made it, to be honest, but they moved me to first class because I guess somebody died. Well, this is the thing that happened. Now I'm standing, and you know when you're standing on a plane, it's the only time you feel like you're 6'5".
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You're like, I'm a tall guy, you know? But now I'm just over people who are watching somebody die, and some people are, I was looking at this one woman who's like, literally, not only turned to look, but turned her kid to look too. And I'm like, hey, move your kid the other way.
Educational, yeah. Okay.
Just holding the kid up.
Yeah.
This is why you do not do drugs.
Yeah.
And then shaking, do not do drugs.
I'm out. Now the baby's convulsing.
Yeah. Different drool over here. Like, you have to just go to first class. We don't have you. You're not helping anybody here. And your eyes are bright red somehow. I don't know. Guy scared me. I realized, like, how does my little brother do this every day? This is ridiculous. But now I'm standing over everybody, and they bring a stretcher, and the guy's now this. And I'm going, oh, no. And everybody's looking, and they kind of have to pin him down to bring him out. And they wheel him out. But the way everybody's eyes followed him, it literally was this, follow him, and then just me. Because I was still standing because there was nowhere to go because that was my seat.
Right.
So I'm just standing over everybody, and I go, so the movie of the flight is going to be Ocean's 8, starring Sandra Bullock and Mindy Kaling. And then everybody laughed. I got to laugh at everybody. Oh. And then they went, we're going to move you to first class. So I got to go sit in first.
But you think it's because the guy drooled all over your seat?
Well,
like a COVID thing, maybe?
I think it was like maybe avoid a lawsuit thing.
All right.
Actually, I don't know why they moved me to first. Maybe because of
maybe
the joke.
Maybe it was a Sandra Bullock joke. Maybe
yeah, it could have been the joke because they did laugh and I calmed everybody down.
Oh, good, good.
Some of the kids were crying and shit, and I was just like, so the movie, that was my deflection.
That's so funny.
And then when they moved me to first, this one lady, this is so New York, this one lady goes, huh, lucky you, huh? And I go,
in first class?
No. Right when I'm going to first.
Fuck.
Like somebody who saw the convulsion, I go, yeah, it's great to have somebody die next to me so that I could go for it. And by the way, yeah. So all I said to her was, I said, work like a charm. We planned it. And then she was like, huh? And I was like, oh. And I realized I'm dressed like a skater too.
You're a team.
We easily could be friends because everybody was questioning me, like, right. What did he have? I go, I don't know him. was like, do I dress that childish? And I realized I am dressed that childish.
I was hoping the person that said, lucky you, huh, was in first class. Like, you showed up to a club you don't belong to.
No, here's what happened at first. Here's what happened at first, though. Because that guy gets wheeled out. Now, keep in mind, the guy's got a hoodie on. He's wearing fucking Converse, you know. And then they move me to first. This dad with his two daughters in front and his wife next to him, obviously a rich business owner, is staring me down. Now, this is definitely my insecurity of being in first class. But I figure, like, what, you don't think I belong here? You know, I'm having, like, that in my head. Because he's staring at me. Because, like, we're in these bucket seats, and he's just doing this to me. And he leans in to his wife and points at me and goes,
oh, that's when I would have said some shit.
Well, here's what I did.
You got a problem?
Here's what I said. Because I'm watching the TV screen, but then I turn my head like this. Like, he's like, where you are? And he's looking at me like that the entire time. So I finally just go, you okay? And then he went like that. I'm like, oh, what?
Here's what I would have done. You're the old guy staring at me. You're the old guy staring at me. Here's what I would have done. And kept doing it until he looked away.
Yeah, that would have been fucking good. It made me nervous the whole flight.
What an asshole.
Yeah, he just like, it's like I didn't belong there and it's bullshit.
What am I in your front yard?
Yeah.
All right.
It's that rich guy attitude bullshit. Sometimes you don't
we
have
do
that.
Know that you didn't
belong. I did not belong there, to be honest. Yeah. I've had a really hard year, so it should not have been up there. But yeah, a kid died, and I got first class, and I have his wire.
His what? Oh, his charger?
Yeah, this is his.
Uh-oh. Mm-hmm. Our seizures?
Look how dirty it is.
Oh, yeah. I just, because, I'm going to be honest with you, and I'm not trying to be insulting.
Yeah.
Because of how dirty it is, I thought it was yours. Yeah.
Fuck you. Because I got topics on it? I'm sorry. Oh, that's the other thing, too. When I said, hey, what were you in L.A. for? He goes, do drugs with my friends. That's what he said to me. He flew to L.A. to do drugs with his friends.
I like the honesty.
Yeah. Jesus. I thought we'd be friends.
How old was this kid?
He had to be like 24. I mean, he seemed young.
So it wasn't Jonathan?
No, it wasn't your son. Your son has a brain.
Yeah, he does. A very big brain. Bigger than my brain, as it turns out.
You know, yeah, that was my way into New York, and now we're going to have a hurricane, so something's happening.
Damn it. We're never going home, dude. This is where we're going to do the lines in from now on.
You have any idea how awesome that would be just to have a view like this? We got to get a shot of the view for the people.
Yeah.
A what?
And by the way, people that came to the first show last night on Friday, we're doing this Saturday before the Tuesday. People that came to that show from the Lions Den podcast warmed our hearts. It was pretty awesome. Nicole, Emil... Yeah. It was great to see you guys.
Emil Carr, who Brent called Carlos.
Yeah, I did. That was a little racist by accident. I just didn't know because he looked at me like we were best friends, and then I panicked and I didn't know what to say.
Have you ever met Carlos?
I never met Carlos.
Oh, that explains it. Carlos is a
San Diego, right?
San Diego guy. Yeah.
So
Emil Carr is a DC guy, and he is adorable.
Yeah, he was such a good shit. Was he wearing a Jason shirt last night?
He was wearing his best friend's Jason Collins' best friend T-shirt.
Yeah, it was pretty cool. You didn't see it because you left.
Yeah, you did that Will thing where you just like, I'm gonna go be weird as shit.
Go do.
I'm gonna go be weird as shit.
I'm gonna go be weird as shit and disappear on the other side of the room.
I'm not gonna let in my two best friends into my own bar show.
Funny though, when Will got back to the club, Emil Carr and Nicole were standing there, and Will goes, Emil Carr. He goes, yeah. Emil Carr goes, well, at least he knows.
Oh fuck. I'm so sorry. Well, fuck it. I'm going to disappoint somebody in this.
They're coming tonight, too. They literally got tickets to all four shows.
Well, then I'm going to have to call him Carlos again for the joke. Mm-hmm.
He is not Carlos.
Yes.
We know or him post now. A picture with the two of you said not Carlos.
Yeah. You're right. He is cute as shit. Okay.
Yeah, he's such a good dude. Good dude. Good fan. Mm-hmm. Very supportive of what we're doing. And we love you.
Can we talk about Will just kind of disappearing on us?
Yeah, that was interesting. First, we did in the beginning of the pod. It was his first time doing the podcast. I mean,
well, I'm not talking about Gotham. I'm talking about like his bar show that he didn't even let us into.
Okay. We need to talk about that. So Will has a fear of conflict and confrontation, like a really trippy fear where it manifests as just normal conversations to you are difficult to have with people.
Sure.
Especially strangers.
I love how he agrees.
Kenny, who runs the Grizzly Pear, they didn't know we were coming. And now, me in that situation, if I was doing a spot and the two of you were coming, I would have went and said, these are my guys. We're here together. I'm going to bring them in to watch the show. Will just dipped into the showroom and left us in the bar. We wanted to watch your set.
Yeah.
See, that I never knew that. I had no idea. I figured you guys would just kick it. I'd go do my spot. We'll come back. No one said that.
How are we supposed to make fun of your set if we don't see it?
Yeah.
I didn't know.
How are we supposed to bust your fucking balls?
I figured if you wanted to go in, you'd go in.
I tried, and then Kenny wouldn't let me in.
Kenny knew, he knows me, so he let me in and gave me the tour and shit, but like,
he put a jiu-jitsu move on Brent.
Well, I figured he would know you just from who you are.
Nobody knew who I was. They know who he is.
Dude, everybody we went into the cellar, and everybody was like...
yeah, nobody knew.
I gotta tell you, man.
Fuck, I must have aged.
I'm gonna be honest as shit about the cellar right now. I can't wait.
You're nervous.
Nervous, excited. However, being a 50-year-old man and a dad and whatever, I'm good on the hanging out there.
Oh, I know what you mean. Yeah.
We were in the bar above the club. It was so uncomfortably fucking loud.
Oh, yeah.
And I don't mean just like noise because it's a bar, but the comics in the booth talking so fucking loud, trying to out-funny each other. Yeah. I was literally like, guys, you've already made it.
Yeah.
Chill out. And it was, that's why going to the Grizzly Pear was much better, because it was more chill.
It was
no
chill.
One's out there trying to fuck a peacock and shit, or whatever you call it. However, I mean, to be a part of that club, I mean, it would just be like a comedy dream come true.
Yeah. That'd be good, too.
Not a life dream, but a comedy dream come
true. I think you're going to kill tonight, man. That club is... Once you're on stage, you're going to go, oh, I can do this. This club's great.
And I've been in the showroom. Yeah. Last time I was here 4 or 5 years ago, whatever it was, somebody let me walk. They walked me in and gave me a little tour of it and everything, and it was really cool. But, I mean, hopefully there'll be some people I know there tonight, because I know a couple of our buddies are now doing cellar shit. But, yeah, I'm a little... I don't know if nervous is the right...
Anxious.
Anxious because I'm not nervous about what I do. Because hey,
it's also just weird.
Hey, wait a minute,
because we walked in there.
It's undeniable. I'm sorry. I love that you're trying to save me from being an asshole.
I was for a second. What he means is we're undeniable. God.
Hey, here's my outlook on that. If I'm not going to believe in me, who the fuck is?
So powerful.
So powerful.
Yep, success don't sleep.
Except when you have to.
What?
Except when you have to sleep.
The only success that sleeps a lot is Will Burkhardt.
Yeah. I could tell that through your text how mad you were today.
Sleeps, dude. And it's so funny. Like, I'm like, I'm the only one who remembers our conversations last night.
Oh, yeah, I completely forgot.
Brent's like, what time are we doing the thing? I go, you don't remember talking about last night? He goes, nope.
Oh.
1 o'clock. Okay, we're going to do it at my place. And then I'm like, you really don't remember last night. He goes, nope. Doing it at Will's apartment. Then Will texts me. He goes, oh, we think about doing it here? Then that's when I texted in the group. Am I the only one that fucking remembers the conversations last night?
Yes.
To be fair, 1 o'clock was the only thing we agreed on. The place we never agreed
on. Yeah, we did.
I didn't think so. I thought we were all over the place. We've never.
I said we're doing it at the living room.
I didn't hear that. That's fine. But
it's not that you didn't. It's okay. Yeah, you're right.
You just got to own it.
You didn't hear it.
He
was sober. You didn't hear it because Dad Matt's coming out. Dad Collings. You didn't hear it because you weren't listening.
Yeah.
You didn't hear it because you didn't want to hear it. But yeah.
See, I just owned it. Instead of backtracking, I was like, nope, totally forgot. Okay, we're doing it there. And now we're in my place.
I wish we could do emails.
Yeah.
Do we have the option if you can get them up on my phone?
Yes.
Yeah.
That's a yes.
He just his doesn't face, want to do there's it. The confrontation issue.
No, it's not like that.
He just didn't want to do it.
He doesn't want to read it. If you can't see Will, he goes,
oh, you have to log out.
You have to like do like Sony login, log out shit. So.
Aren't you already logged in the Lion's Den email?
What
was his voice in?
I'm going to tell you. Here we go. Will's gonna love this, why I logged out. Will was getting so mad that I was...
Reading them
because he didn't know which ones were red and which ones weren't. And I have my one of my things with my crazy OCD shit is when I have a notification, I have to read it.
It's the same thing with Instagram, like, too.
I had to log out of that one, too.
Someone would write us and then he'd read it in a minute. Because
I can't have the notification. What is it called? The badge?
My phone
the
would
number?
Give you an anxiety attack. Man.
Oh, my God.
There's so many unread things on my phone.
Oh, dude, Skylar. Every time I look at Skylar Stone's phone, 750,000 unread texts. Ooh. Oh, it makes me mad. I wake up in the morning and from group texts, and if it's 3 digits, I'm like, oh, really? I'm not reading any of it. I'm not reading any of it. Oh, God, let me see. Let me see your notifications.
Well, I have 8 unread DMs. No, actually, 100 and something unread. Oh, wow.
Who?
Drake.
No, no way. Did he ask about Will?
He asked for tickets to the show tonight.
Oh, tell him we're sold out.
Yep.
Yeah. Sorry, Drake.
Sorry, Drake.
We
sold out.
Yeah, there we go.
Kisses. Mm-hmm. Awesome.
He used to call me on my cell phone.
Oh.
Thanks, Will.
Oh, I get that now. You used to call me on my cell phone. Yeah, I got distracted now. 15 unread text, though.
Let me see. But you know what's even worse? 34 missed phone calls.
Oh, yeah.
Open that so that number goes away.
Well, it's 34 voicemails.
So anybody who's leaving Brent's messages, guess what? He's not listening.
It's just people all day. It starts at 6 a.m.
I only have one.
It does not stop.
Hi, Brent. This is your doctor. So yeah, important medical information. Mm-hmm.
Well, hey, doc. Come meet me at my house then. Because I'm not dealing with this. No, it's usually people asking me for things. So I just stop listening to them. Hey, Brent, do you mind doing this for me? Hey, can you do this for me? Hey, can you do this for me? Hey, is there any way I could get this? Can I do this? It's like, no. Guys, I'm home. I have pandas, and I don't know what's happening. Okay? And I'm getting bit by goddamn spiders every fucking day, and I'm throwing up. Mm. That's what I figured it out. I don't think it was food poisoning. Like this here and this were two spider bites. I had a black widow nest in my house. And
you think that was making you throw up?
It was making me really sick because I was really sick. And then this thing wouldn't go away. It still hasn't gone away.
You got one on the side, too.
Yeah.
You're going to hang a coat on that one.
This one I was... this one I took a pin to, a needle
ew,
to.
Ew.
Because it was out here because it was so fucking whatever, venom or something. Because my throat was closing. And I went, what is happening to my throat? And I realized above the vent in my living room, above that is all these, like it was a baby nest of spiders, and they were coming down while I'm sleeping because you know I fall asleep on
and
the couch.
Gnawing on your neck.
And just going, I'm an asshole. I'm an asshole. Penis. I'm an asshole.
Did they bite you on your peepee?
I had one near my penis. Yeah.
Man.
Hopefully your dick still works.
Hairs anymore. This is done.
They were sucking the venom out of your snake, huh?
Well, maybe we could swell it up one day. You know what I'm saying?
It'd be a normal size anyway.
Hey, come on.
Sorry.
I've already called myself hook penis on this show. Tell me what robot that looks like from what movie?
Johnny Five.
Yes!
Short Circuit.
I knew you would
boom.
Get it.
Boom. It's the lamp over here. People are so... I just got a text that it's people are so more acclimated to texting now.
Yeah.
That when you call them, they think something's wrong.
I feel like that way.
I gave our buddy Chris a call earlier. Because I wanted to ask him about some shit.
Yeah.
He just texts me, are you okay? Yes.
Yes.
I'm also 50.
Yeah, also on top of that though.
And I make phone calls, Chris.
With me, he always goes, don't call me when I call.
Oh, that's funny. He's not rude to me like that.
Yeah, because with me, he's like, ugh, you're going to try to talk to me about life or something. And with you, he's probably like, Jason doesn't really call me that much. Like,
we talk every day via text, but I wanted to talk to him because I wanted to hear true feelings.
Yes, exactly.
Not robot feelings.
Dude, I was literally texting with my brother like when he's leaving Penn Station and the pizza place we're at is right next to Penn Station. And I'm writing a text and I literally go, what am I doing? Just call him. I go, hey, yes, to the left, right here, as opposed to me having a fucking... text where we are.
So many people's voicemail is like, hey guys, sorry, can't get to the phone right now. Leave a voicemail, but if you want to get a hold of me quicker, leave a text.
They really?
Yeah.
That's a thing now? Do you do that?
No. I don't even have a voicemail greeting.
Oh, I don't fuck
so
with that
cool.
at all. I don't either.
Yeah. I don't know.
I don't either. Because I want people to not be sure if they're getting a hold of me.
Yeah, no one really has that.
Please leave your message.
Was that just you doing the voice of it?
Yeah. It's just me going, hello. Welcome
I think I
to
have
the
a,
phone.
I think I have a kind of a joke. I don't know what my voice
is. Yours is just you. Like,
it's you and then Rick in the background.
Is it really?
It's you like, hey, this is Brent Morin, and then you say a very basic thing and you hear Rick go, do it again. And Brent goes, nope.
Oh, yes.
Really?
Yes. Because him and John DeWalt would always, yes.
Yeah,
I'm very curious.
It's actually really funny.
Put it up to the, somebody, when you call, put it on speaker, put it up to the phone.
Talk about Rick Glassman, by the way.
I wonder if I'll pick up.
Hello?
No.
Sorry.
We're trying to hear your voicemail here. Come on, man.
Cut.
Well, I'm just trying to cut down on my messages.
Push. Yeah, just send it to voicemails.
This is Brent Morin. Leave a message after the beep, and I will get back to you.
Do it again?
Nope.
That is funny. I've never heard that. That's really funny.
Oh, I miss him.
Do it again. Nope.
Because him and John would always do these joke ones. I go, you guys can't do that if you know people are going to call you that have jobs, you know?
And then
I was trying to do a normal one like 10 times. Now I remember it. Those were the good old days, the apartment days. You know why I do this? You can't see my leg do that, huh?
Do it again.
Can you see that?
Yeah.
Okay. You know why I do this? Can you guess?
No.
Really? This is going to be... You know, people have been questioning my sexuality. I'm not gay. But I saw Brad Pitt do this at Fight Club after getting his ass kicked. Where he's all like this and he goes... So now sometimes I'll just be sitting at a bar and go... Yeah.
You know, and then everybody's like, that guy just had a fight.
Yeah, no, they're like, that guy has diabetes.
Mine is... Dude, I'm all day just...
Yeah, that guy's had a lot of constructive knee surgery.
Yeah. And then Brent was making fun of me the other day when I got out of his car. He's like, I'm not going to... He says... The funniest thing is to say you're not going to mention something by mentioning it. Yeah. He goes, I'm not going to mention that that took two rocks for you to get out of the car. Because I was like...
You know what's funny? That's how I judge if I have a box in my stomach. Is when I have to do this for my couch. You know? I'm like, oh, Brent, that is not a good sign.
I remember my dad getting up and down from the couch was always just like... And then,
you know what I realize I'm doing? I used to think about this all the time. Well, my little brother used to get really pissed at my dad about this. I didn't really get mad at it. I just thought it was man noises. But every morning when we wake up for school, my dad would always be... And then he'd pour the coffee.
That's the
worst. Like all the time. And then I didn't care. But my little brother goes,
My brother used to do that shit to me.
He's like, stop it,
dude,
Dad.
Dude, when me and my brother used to share a room,
yeah,
he got so pissed if I moved slightly in bed.
That's funny.
And then he would just start going, making fun of me doing it. Buddy, there was an episode of Black Mirror, and I can't remember what it was about, but it was like you ended up in a couple and things and whatever couple you ended up in, there was like this luck of the draw thing, how long it would last. Sometimes it'll be 3 days.
Yeah,
sometimes
it's like the dating app one.
Yeah.
It's a good one.
Dude, there's this one where the couple's laying in bed together and everything's perfect until they're in bed together at night and the guy pours himself a cup of coffee and they're watching TV. And every time he did, he went like this. And the girl kind of goes, and he just doesn't even know. She's like, and I thought that would drive me
insane.
The funniest thing about my brother though getting pissed about me moving and not is now I cannot sleep in the same room with him. If we're on a trip together in a hotel room, there I have all the rules. I'm like, you need to sleep sitting up.
Yeah.
Like he's the fucking elephant man. Like he's John Merrick. He has to sit up. Because if you remember anything about the elephant man, if he's laid down like a normal person, he would die in his sleep.
Yeah.
I was like, you have to sit up because my brother is just snoring, right? That's how he snores. It's unbelievable. And I'm like, you sound like a donkey. You sound like a donkey. And the thing that shocks me the most, because I'm gonna be honest, I spent the night here the other night with
Brent. Yeah, this is bad. I have stigmata, though.
Brent snoring? First of all,
trumps it.
First of all, once he falls asleep and starts snoring, it's because he's so tired from all the other fucking activity he's been doing for the last hour during his sleep. At one point, he sticks his legs straight. Anyways,
I can't. No, you could tell them that. So what was I doing? Because I've always wondered.
He stuck his legs straight up. I'm sleeping here and I'm looking at the bed. Legs straight up, and he goes. Oh.
I don't know what's happening in my dreams.
And then he chills out, and then at one point he goes, she's acting kind of weird. Just says that.
In my sleep?
Yeah. All kinds of shit was going on. Talking, yelling, screaming, laughing, running. fucking apparently.
I know you. I guarantee this was you the whole time.
Just oh, one position.
Looking at me, just going
out.
Well, I'll tell you this. I woke up that next day, and first off, my hair was
probably
always
sore. You were probably sore as fuck.
I was sore.
Yeah.
But you were running, dude. My hair was in a wind tunnel, and all the sheets were off the bed, and the blanket was down there, and all the pillows were down.
And you were crossways. When I left, you were crossways.
That's how I've been waking up here this way.
Snoring the most loud.
I'm dying.
Not quite as loud as my brother. But here's the thing that blows my mind about the loud, loud, loud snoring. How is it not waking you up?
Yeah.
Like, I've had my snoring wake me up. Like, oh.
Yeah, my dad's snoring.
My brother just. And I'm like, Jesus.
I was wondering when that was going to happen.
How is that not waking him up? It's so bad that one time, the last time Dave and I did a road trip together, we went to, I think you went to Vegas with me.
Oh, like, yeah, Vegas? That's right. I think it was Vegas.
Yeah, we did a, I did a one-nighter in Vegas, and they I brought David with me. At one point, he got silent, and was asleep, so obviously I thought he was dead.
Yeah.
I got nervous, and I'm looking at him, and he's just...
Oh, that's...
peaceful.
Yeah.
So I felt bad, but I'm like, I have to wake him if you... So I wanted to make sure he was alive, because it was silent. I should have done the mirror under the nose, but instead I went, Dave.
Yeah.
Dave.
It's a different drool.
And he went like this, huh? I go, oh, nothing. He goes, okay.
My cousin, a bigger, better Brent. My cousin Brendan looks like a Colin Farrell with better eyebrows. And he's so handsome. Really, and then I saw him fall asleep. He sleeps handsome. Like, his hair dangles in his face and his mouth is... And it's just that. And I watched him for a long time going, we have some of the same blood.
Yeah.
Is he going to snore? And I realized, only does he not snore.
He sleeps like this.
He sleeps very hot. And yeah.
like this, look.
Yeah. And I'm like, meanwhile, I'm like, if I had a girl ever in my bed, she's off the bed. And I don't know where I am. I'm surprised you didn't wake up and I was floating above this.
I honestly would not have been surprised. She's acting kind of weird. Oh, man.
What the hell was I thinking about?
Well, you probably... How did Mike sleep last night?
Oh, Mike has been talking to his wife. He goes, yeah, I think Brent has sleep apnea and he's got issues, so I'm not really sleeping here. He's very dry sense of humor, so he's also dead honest with me.
Yeah.
And he goes, I said, did I sleep... I warned him beforehand. I go, just so you know, I'm not a great sleeper. And he goes, hey, man, I have 3 daughters. I'll be all right. And then he goes, yeah, you're fucking weird, man. It's not good.
At some point, it sounded violent.
Yeah.
It's not so much that you're not a good sleeper. It's that it's very hard to be in the same room as you when you're sleeping.
And
like, it's not so bad for you.
Yeah.
I mean, he finds a way to say something even more painful. You did a whole act out of me sleeping that hurt less than what he just said.
You know why? Because what you can't see is he's leaning against the wall with his arms crossed while he's fucking saying it.
It's not that you're a bad sleeper. It's just that no one wants to be around you ever when you're sleeping because you're a lonely man and no one ever
single
wants to be with you.
Shocker. Yeah. Anyways.
How the hell am I ever going to date anyone? Who can
you know what?
That?
You have to be a multimillionaire so that you and your wife can have separate bedrooms.
No, this is what I'll end up doing. I'll have that fucking mask and I'll go, it's very nice meeting you.
Oh, man.
Want to get brunch tomorrow?
My buddy Joe has sleep apnea. Joe Coy.
Yeah, Coy does, yeah.
We did a road gig together where we stayed in the same room like this, and he was like...
Did he have the machine?
Yeah, but he was like, do not take pictures. Do not, because I wanted to videotape it. I wanted to send it to my brother. Like, yeah, I'm sleeping next to Darth Vader over here. Yeah, but he wouldn't.
It's fucking ridiculous. It's like, you can't even sleep right.
Anyways.
I mean, I'm so anxious in my sleep. I don't know. That was my Woody Allen, which, by the way, I realized can't talk about him. And also, that didn't work on multiple levels.
I almost went in at it and said, I'm his wife. He sleeps just fine.
He used to tuck
me I've in. Been sleeping with him since. Sorry, not funny.
Yeah, it's not funny.
It's hilarious. But anyways.
We're in New York. That's
yes.
made me think about
speaking of that,
movies.
Let's get the fuck out of here and go explore. You guys want to do a Patreon?
Let's do a Patreon.
Yeah, let's just continue over on Patreon.
Let's do a Patreon. All right.
Stop touching your penis.
Thank you guys for joining us here on the Lies Den Podcast. If you are a Patreon member, we're going to keep it going. Thanks. We are friends.